Hello everyone, my name is Jay Deschamps. Thank you for joining. I'm here today to talk to you about how to take your online meeting, webinar, teaching or training event to the next level. So we all have Zoom fatigue, Microsoft Teams fatigue, online meeting fatigue. So how can you compel your audience, tell your story better, and take it to the next level? Use some camera presets. Move around your space. Add picture-in-picture and some on-screen graphics. That helps engage the audience and tell your story. So how do you do that? Well, basically what you need to do is add a PTZ camera. I use the RoboSHOT 12 here from Vadio. AV Bridge 2x1 or an EasyIP Mixer, they both will do the job. And a computer, which I imagine you probably already have. So let me show you some examples. Let's go to the whiteboard. We're gonna start with a close-up of the whiteboard. And you can take that close-up, talk about the whiteboard, or zoom back if you wanna be part of the engagement. Use those camera presets to move around your office and engage your audience. Now you can also add picture-in-picture up in the upper right-hand corner. That's a slide, PowerPoint slide from my computer. Picture-in-picture can be either corner, any of the four corners, top, bottom, or left, right, as you can see from the graphic. So it really helps tell your story and change the content up a little bit. So let me show you what a side-by-side would look like with some branding around it. So on the left is my computer, on the right, as you can see, is a live camera. Let's go over to the table and show you some camera moves and some graphics. So I've got a couple of cameras here I'm using as props. I've got the conference shot and a huddle shot. So let's zoom in on the conference shot AV, show some graphics down in the bottom, lower third, show you what the conference shot is. I've got some graphics in the upper right to talk about the family of products. And then actually, if you want to take a little closer look, we'll turn the camera around and we'll zoom in on the camera to give you a shot of the back panel. So depending on what you're teaching or training on, you can actually use these camera moves and move between them to help tell your story. So let's talk about what else is on the table. I said we have a huddle shot here too. So I want to show some camera moves here. I'm going to zoom in on the microphone, bring up a lower third graphic just to talk about what we're doing. It's a newly designed EasyMic desktop mic. And we'll just take a nice slow camera move across the product so you can take a look at the product. And then come back to me. So this entire move was done with one macro, several commands, but one macro, one button push. And I want to show you how to do that. So let's go back over to the computer. This is a slide from the computer, PowerPoint slide. Let me sit back down so I can drive. So as I've talked several times about the AV Bridge 2x1, I want to show this and contrast it with the EasyIP Mixer. So very similar products, both great products, just different inputs for the camera. AV Bridge 2x1 has two HDMIs, EasyIP Mixer has camera inputs from the IP stream, from the network. So they're EasyIP cameras from Vadio. And then there's one HDMI in to use for your computer. Dante the same, audio, all the audio ins and outs, including Dante, macros, everything I did today will work on the EasyIP Mixer or the AV Bridge 2x1 exactly the same. So I've mentioned macros several times. Let's talk about what a macro really is and how they work. So there's three simple command lines here that's a sample of what a macro is. Camera one, so you have to tell which camera you want to control. So I'm doing camera one, preset recall three. I'm saying, hey, camera one, go to preset recall three. I'm just telling the camera where to go. Video program, which means the output, picture in picture, PIP, turn layout on upper right. So enable the upper right layout and then video program, turn PIP on. So that would move a camera and turn picture in picture on. Real simple command line syntax, just get in the manual and you can look it up. So what do you do with those triggers? Once they're defined, you can obviously through software triggers, you could do it with the Vadio device controller, a web GUI, or Crestron AMX or other third-party controllers. You could say, trigger that, just like a button press. You can do other things with those GUIs. Obviously they're full GUI interfaces. Or you can use hardware triggers, which are just simple contact closures. You could have a motion sensor in the ceiling. You could have trigger buttons on the wall. Vadio sells a device to do trigger buttons. You could have a step mat. I could have a step mat in front of my whiteboard. When I step on it, it would automatically go there. And those all interface just through the five GPI triggers. So let's bring up the AV Bridge 2x1 web GUI and take a look at how that all works. So how did I get this in my office to do what I needed it to do? First thing I had to set up were the camera presets. So I'm on the video input tab on the web GUI. I've zoomed it a little bit so you can see it simpler. So I set up these particular moves. So I have seven, in this case, camera moves that I use to go around my whiteboard and table. First one is me sitting here. The second one is the whiteboard. So I click that, goes to the whiteboard. I can come back to me. So you can manually just click around if you want to just simply do that. I automated that. So I set my presets. Then I went into the graphics side and I loaded the graphics that I wanted to use to tell my story. I used PNG files and transparency so that they'd look a little nicer. You can see the graphics here. But to secret sauce, go into the control devices tab. Secret sauce is the macros. You can see I've got a whiteboard macro here. I've got the table demo macro. And they get a little long because there were a lot of moves I did there. I wanted to make them fairly complex so you could see all the things that could be done. But I have one here called demo that I want to show that's a little simpler. And I can zoom it up a bit so you can see a little better. So the demo one, let me fire it first. So once you write the macro and name it, I'll hit a test and you can see what it'll do. So it goes to me for 2 seconds. It's going to go up to my whiteboard. It's going to pause there, bring up a lower third graphic, the bottom, take the graphic off the screen, then come back to me, then dissolve to my laptop and put me in the lower right-hand corner in a picture-in-picture. So that was what happened with these particular command lines. Video program source input one, choose camera input one, turn picture-in-picture off. So take this particular screen, turn it off, go to preset recall two, which is the whiteboard, pause, sleep 3000 is a pause command for 3 seconds. Set the graphic source to a PNG file, which is that lower third, turn it on, pause again, turn graphics off, come back to me, turn picture-in-picture on, pause for 4 seconds. And then go to input two, which is the laptop, and turn picture-in-picture back on, which puts us back here where we are with the laptop in the background, me in the lower third. So that's how you do macros. It might look a little complicated if you haven't done any, it's not really programming, it's just command line interface. So play with it, try it out. The instructions are in the manual. What do you do once you define these? So they're named, this one's called demo, the other two were called whiteboard. So you go into the triggers section. And here I have hardware triggers and software triggers. So hardware one, I used whiteboard, and hardware two was my table demo. So with one button press, I did what you saw at the whiteboard and at the table. So with that, I just want to thank everybody for coming. I really appreciate you spending the time with me. I'll just end it with one more macro. And as you can see what we have here, see me on the left and my computer on the right. So thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions, get with your LeGrand AV sales representative. Visit us on legrandav.com or follow us on Twitter or LinkedIn. Have a great day.